Well, normally she's cooking up consumer stories in the CTV newsroom. Today we have pulled Laura Lowe into the CTV kitchen to share a holiday recipe. So thanks for coming.
Thank you. Thank you. And, you know, speaking of normally I'm working on consumer watch stories, trying to help you save money. Well, my favorite thing to do is cook and bake at home because, again, you're saving, right? You can have more delicious things than what you buy pre-made.
Yes.
If you're making it home. It just takes a little bit of work to do it.
And it's probably better for you.
That's what I figure. And exactly. So that's why I say I can eat all these butter tarts because they're good for me, right?
Exactly.
I made them at home.
Okay. So how do we make these?
Okay. So, well, first of all, what I did is made the crust last night because it does take a lot of work.
Okay,
we wouldn't
so
have enough time for that. So that,
because you can cheat on that one pretty easily.
Absolutely will not. In fact, if you make this at home, which you should, do not cheat on the crust. I will not stand behind this recipe if you cheat on the crust. And
deal.
The most important thing about this crust is using lard, not shortening.
Okay.
Again, if you use shortening, don't even bother making it.
Yeah.
That adds to the
flavor.
That is
going to void your warranty.
I will void my warranty.
Okay.
The lard makes it taste smooth. So many times with tarts, I find there's a bitter taste to it. And you probably won't realize until you sample this.
Okay.
But it makes it just smooth and delicious. So that's the key. And this is all coming from Grandma Atkinson. So on mom's side. It may be have even more history from Grandma Atkinson. Unfortunately, she isn't with us any longer. But Grandma Atkinson made it. And then my mom made it. And of course, I've taken over making it. So rolled these out last night.
Yep.
Filled little cups. And then we're going to whip up the actual filling for the butter tarts. So got everything pre-mixed. Our first step here is one cup of brown sugar. I'm actually doubling the recipe because we have 12 cups. It says 12 tarts make this mixture, but my mom is known to shortchange a little bit on the sweets.
You'd really, really, really shallow tart.
Yeah, she's
that's
the person that on cupcakes, you just get like a thin layer of icing.
No.
Yeah,
we're
so
not
that's why
that
I'm doubling this one up.
Thank
exactly.
you. Much appreciated.
Yep. So here's our brown sugar.
Oh, it's nice and soft.
It is. Yeah, you need to
keep that. That must be new.
Well, you keep it in a sealed container, and that way you're always going to keep it soft. I even
doesn't
use
seem to work.
Well, you know what? I use zipper bags.
Yes,
like,
that
and they
it.
Keep them.
And I should probably touch it more than like once a year. That might help.
Exactly. You need to get baking more. So butter.
Okay.
Is our next.
So that is how much butter?
It should be 2 to 3 tablespoons, but we're doubling it. So I did 5.
Okay.
And margarine is fine. That's what I'm using.
Gotcha.
1 egg, so we're doubling that again. Do you want to throw those
in? Yeah, we'll do 2 eggs.
Okay, I have a problem that I get shells sometimes.
I might do, but you know what? We just won't tell anybody.
Yeah, that's true, except we're going to eat these.
Oh, yeah. See, no shells so far, so good.
Our next move is a dash of salt. You'll notice.
Must use a festive shaker.
It must use a festive shaker.
We'll also void your warranty if you do not.
There's 2 dash my hands of salt.
2 dashes?
Yeah, you got it.
That's easy.
Vanilla? I'm using the artificial vanilla extract.
It's okay.
Should probably use
you can get
the
real stuff.
I know, but
who
again,
my
frugality got me and I'm using the...
Nothing wrong with that.
Oops. You know what? And
that was
I,
a big pour. That's all good.
I must say, I do enjoy cooking a little more than baking because that's how, when I'm cooking, I don't measure anything. I just dump it in. And sometimes that happens to my baking and...
It doesn't always work out well.
Although
I'm sure it will.
Yep.
So I was so your butter tarts don't look like a normal butter tart.
Oh, great. Thanks,
you know, usually
Marty.
They're like
thanks. I really appreciate this. I'm sharing a family recipe with you and
it's not normal.
Right. Okay.
But usually they're like brown and kind of syrupy, but these ones have some substance.
Well, usually butter tarts have like a jelly sort of filling, right? These ones, when you take a bite, you're going to notice that they're runny, and that's on purpose.
Okay.
That's how they're supposed to be. So we're just going to finish up whipping this. I'm going to put the coconut in.
Yep.
And
I think that's what gives it the extra texture and the light color.
Yep. The raisins. The nuts are an option. I'm not a huge fan, so
You know what?
I leave those out. Oh, perfect. So I'm just going to mix this up.
Oh, that's pretty easy.
Yeah, very easy. The crust really is the more time-consuming part of it. So mix this
up. But you
can't
cheat it.
No, you cannot. Okay, and then we just drop them in the little cups here.
Nice. And they're not going to rise at all because there's nothing in there to rise. So you can go right to the very top.
Yeah, you can. Exactly.
All right.
Yep.
And is this something you have every Christmas at your house?
Every Christmas.
Nice.
A lot of times when I'm home, my mom will make them or Aunt Meg will make them. They swap back and forth. But somebody has to have them. Like the Christmas.
Somebody has to be in charge of it.
I'm not kidding. If there were not butter tarts, we would go from December 24th to the 26th. There would be no Christmas if butter tarts were not at our family.
Somebody would
dinner.
Have to get up at the crack of dawn to get it done, or Christmas is ruined.
It's exactly. Yeah, okay. It's very, very important. So do you want to sample them?
I do. So we are going to find this recipe online.
Yeah.
You can go to our website and then click on news links, the holiday recipes link. Tomorrow it's Craig Larkins, and he's changed his mind about 1,000 times at what he's going to make. So that's a surprise.
Well, yeah, it's a
okay,
little
but I'm going for a butter tart.
Can
now.
I mention
how long
too,
do you cook these?
You cook them for 12 minutes.
Okay. Yeah. And do you want to mention
that I just feel a little nervous sharing this because it's a family recipe. So please follow it closely.
It's like the Colonel's secret.
It is.
Exactly. All right. Thank you.
Thanks.
Now I'm going to eat it.